Hi, I'm Karyn Bryant for MMA H.E.A.T. I'm speaking with Liu PingYuan, who is fighting in RUFF 5 on Saturday night in Inner Mongolia. I want to say thank you for joining me, and I know this is a big fight for you. It's a rematch. You lost your first fight with your opponent, so how do you feel going into the second time?
他说这个周末的比赛是一个复赛，然后第一次是输给张美轩，所以这一次什么感觉？这个复赛，这次比赛对我来说很重要，因为。 我已经参加入就是RUFF比赛一年了，在这一年比赛当中，已经跟RUFF一起成长，就是我的技术还有我的就是参赛经验都有所提高，不像第一次，就是刚接触就是 MMA 就是笼子八角笼子，就是这次会是一个不一样的我。So
if you could remind people. What happened in the first fight, and what you've done to make sure it doesn't happen in the second one?
请你简单的谈一谈，就第一场比赛的情况如何，就是怎么过的，然后结果是什么，然后为了避免同样的结果，你这一次是做了什么样的调整？第一场比赛我的就是我的打法就是太单一了，就是太着急去就是降服对手，就是。 被对手就是防的，就是防老一直防着，就是防着我下地面，就是 take down。然后，这次的调整就是比较全面一点，就是站立也多打一点站立，因为我相信我的站立，也相信我的就是地面。Very
nice, very nice. So for people who haven't seen you fight yet, obviously this fight's going to be open to so many more people around the world. How do you describe yourself as a fighter and do you have any signature moves or favorite moves at all?
如何形容自己的那个搏击风格呢？然后你自己有没有一个特别擅长的东西，就非常擅长的一个，比如说一个动作或者一个？我的就是我的风格就是搏击风格就是，比较全面一点嘛，就是站立比赛也可以打 ，MMA 比赛也可以打，就是最注重的还是就是。 站立到摔，就是到 take down 摔到地面，就是打击啊控制，就是不是太单一的，就是不是太单一的站立技术就是好还是地面技术好，两个都可以。What
was it that made you decide to turn into a professional fighter instead of going to college? You're only 19 years old, and a lot of people at your age, I'm sure, have chosen a very different path.
你今年19岁，你为什么选择了MMA而没有比如说上大学呢？因为
MMA 这项运动在国外就是非常流行，然后在中国呢，现在也普及的很遍，中国这个 RUFF 赛事，更让我确信，我会成为一位。
Well, that is interesting because obviously we know it is growing around the world very quickly. Can you explain how popular it is in China? I mean, are you recognized walking down the street, or does everybody know what MMA is now, or are you still trying to explain it even though it's growing fast?
就跟MMA在国内，到底就达到了什么样的普及率？他的问题是你，比如说在老家的时候，在路上会不会陌生人认识你？然后他让你具体的讲一讲这个普及率，然后给一些例子。这个就是在很多杂志上，这很多杂志上都有现在都有这个中国 MMA 的，就是也有一个排行榜，中国选手的排行榜，然后还有就是，比如电视台啊，还有广告啊，还有就是。 报纸啊，都类似都有普及，然后这个每次回家在车上、火车上，也有人认出来，认出我，就是说你打 rock 吗？然后就会问。That's
great. That's great. I don't know if you're single or not, but I would think that would be a good thing to be. You know, very popular over there.
你单身的吗？
目前还是。
That's good. So, what would it mean to you if you could be named first Chinese champion?
能拿到首挑的这个冠军金腰带，那个金腰带对你来说有什么意义？
这个对我来说很重要，因为这是一个中国的冠军，属于中国的 MMA， 属于中国的一条金腰带。 这个是不仅是一种荣誉的象征，也是一种对于我个人来说，我这么年轻，也是给我打了就是一针，就是很有强力的镇静剂吧。
And since this is a great opportunity to talk to the world about yourself and about the Chinese style, is there something you'd like people to know about the way you approach a fight, either personally or sort of mentally, how Chinese fighters might be different from other fighters that we've seen?
他想知道，因为现在我们的世界有很多 MMA 的那个选手，他想知道中国的 MMA 选手，跟国外的 MMA 选手在心理上、在身体上、在搏击风格上有哪些那个区别呢？
中国的 MMA 选手现在就是，风格就是在国外的，就是国外的 MMA 选手就是，相对来说就是体力比中国选手要好一点嘛，就是在体格上他们就是降体重幅度会很大，在中国这个就是现在已经慢慢开始在向国际接轨了，在美国选手就是比较。他们比较更利于擅长笼子里边的，就是，到笼子边上就是怎么去摔，怎么去控制，然后这个是比中国选手要擅长这一点。
Well, we're looking forward to it, and I know you've got to cut some weight, and it's late there, so I don't want to hear you say tomorrow that you were too tired for your fight. So, I want to thank you for talking with me, and good luck to you and looking forward to the stream.
他说已经很晚了，他希望你明天起床的时候不会说因为这个采访你非常的累，你打不出自己的那个风格，所以非常感谢你，然后希望有下一次。
谢谢 ，Thank you.